Filmmakers like myself are driven by an innate passion to tell other people's stories. But we seldom become part of the story. That all changed when I met The Rock. As a young boy, I vividly recall watching the surfers at Killer Dana enjoying the powerful waves and natural beauty that was Dana Point. To give us some perspective, the large rocks seen in the ocean at the top of this picture is still there at the viewpoint behind the Dana Point Ocean Institute. Here are a few pictures of my mother overlooking a natural Dana Point in 1963. My personal connection to The Rock began in 1966 when my mother, a folk singer, was asked to perform at the harbor dedication ceremony. My grandfather took the only color pictures that I have seen. After the ceremony, my parents received this letter from Supervisor Alton Allen thanking them for providing music for the event.
Nancy was Miss Dana Point in 1966 when they had the ceremony for placing the time capsule into the rock.
Amazing, yeah. The harbor wasn't here, so we would come down the big windy road down to the beach and go into the little pristine little coves and the sandy beaches and go surfing. It was very pristine and raw and very natural, and before there was a lot of development. We had the big harbor opening, and I cut the ribbon, and it was a new start for Dana Point.
We were a business in Sacramento Pier in 1971 when the harbor opened, and we moved up here to be the first tenants in the harbor. We brought the Clemente, the Sum Fund, the Real Fund up here, then we've built other boats since then, but we've been here since the harbor opened.
Little did we know that the building of the Dana Point Harbor would usher in the beginning of such growth and change to our sleepy beach towns. Weathered by nearly 50 years of sitting where it began at the base of the original Dana Point Harbor jetty, it was easy to walk by the rock that was next to the steps to Doheny Beach. Few probably realized its significance or the local historical treasures that were sealed within its soul. But that was soon to change, and the amazing secrets encased within the time capsule would soon be revealed. On Thursday, May 5th, 2016, After being encased in concrete for nearly 50 years, it was time for the rock to be freed from its mooring. Powerful machinery that created the harbor was now being used to free its special guests of 50 years. On Friday, May 6, 2016, the day for the rock to be transported to the Cooper Center in Santa Ana to remove the time capsule had come. Maybe in some magic way orchestrated by the rock itself, an unusual May storm greeted us. The wind blew and the rain fell as we gathered to watch the crew from OC Parks finally remove it from its home in the harbor. Orange County Supervisor and local resident Lisa Bartlett helped us dedicate this important event.
Today, we take a peek into the past. OC Parks heavy equipment operators are hard at work removing this historic boulder from Dana Point Harbor. On August 29, 1966, a special ceremony marked the beginning of the county's construction of Dana Point Harbor. As part of the ceremony 50 years ago, this large rock with a plaque sealing a time capsule within was placed near the water. On that day, visitors were promised another ceremony in 2016 would reveal the contents of the time capsule. In preparation for the event on August 29, 2016, we are removing this 8-ton boulder and will take it to the John D. Cooper Archeological and Paleontological Center in Santa Ana. On August 29, 2016, when the rock is in its new location in the harbor, we'll find out exactly what's in the time capsule.
When I began editing this footage of our trip to the Cooper Center, I realized how much the rock had connected my family through the years. Now it was my turn to return the favor and tell the rock's timeless story. Once the rock arrived, teams from OC Parks and the Cooper Center wasted no time in attempting to remove the time capsule cover to verify that the time capsule was inside. Rumors have existed for many years that have questioned the existence of the time capsule.
Hi, I'm Jerry Lips, the director of the Cooper Center, and we're on the Cooper Center campus here, and this big rock behind us has been just delivered about half an hour ago, and it contains a historical capsule that was put in there 50 years ago.
Then we saw it. The time capsule. This was my Indiana Jones moment. Pretty cool. On Wednesday, May 18th, 2016, the day had come to open the time capsule and free all of its important contents from a nearly 50-year sleep. Orange County Supervisor Lisa Bartlett was again in attendance as Orange County Assistant Archivist Chris Jepson and the staff from the Cooper Center opened up the time capsule.
Welcome to the Cooper Center, where we will open the time capsule placed here in Dana Point Harbor in 1966. The Cooper Center is a county facility staffed by Cal State Fullerton professors and students, housing artifacts dating back 180 million years. But today, we will look 50 years into the past. OC Parks recently removed the boulder holding the time capsule and brought it here to the Cooper Center. Is everyone ready to open the time capsule and see what's inside?
Yeah! Hey! Yay! Let me pull the hand back in.
Wow. It's a boy! Another business card.
1982.
Ralph Hudson, who was the landscape architect, is the engineer.
Cattle brand of Mission San Juan Capistrano.
Wow.
1776, 1838.
We have an inventory here of what's inside.
Yeah. More cattle brands. This is James Irvine's cattle brand, J.I. Teodosio Yorba's.
The general design of Dana Point Harbor.
Wow, look at that.
Newspapers from the Boys Club Extra.
The original Orange County magazine.
Oh, that's great.
Cattle brand of Jose Sepulveda.
Right.
For his 48,000 acre Rancho San Joaquin, branded by Mexico. So, the Irvine Ranch. There we go.
Another one.
Looks like we have some images of the harbor.
Boy Scouts of America 1965 annual report.
Dana Point Yacht Club.
Dana Point Yacht Club.
Ralph Quackenbush.
Ralph Quackenbush.
He owned the villa.
We're packaged because.
Oh, the rock placing ceremony. Here's notes inviting people to be part of the rock placing ceremony in 1966. Here's the idea of what the harbor was going to look like.
That's the day they closed the harbor.
Well, certainly Doris is here in spirit. The last day surfing was allowed at Dana Cove, August 14th, 1966. The cove surf was ideal for beginners. It was considered by many the best surfing area in Southern California. At times there were about 150 surfers on the water at one time in the cove. Assigned Ron Drummond.
The letter to us in 1960.
Says, as you open this time capsule, we pray that the orderly progress and development of this area for which we have all worked will have been achieved. We hope, however, that in the years that have passed, the treasure of the history of this area has not been overlooked.
They had documents here, here, and here. And then these were put together like that. And it's a very tight fit, so I can't shove it all the way in. But then it was taped with duct tape from the 1960s.
The original ticket given to all the presentees at the rock placing ceremony. And on the back side, it's the plaque.
Like the dreamers of the past that envisioned the creation of the Dana Point Harbor, new visionaries have come forward to create a new harbor for future generations to enjoy. On Wednesday, June 29th, the harbor revitalization shovel ceremony was held next to where the Rock had lived for 50 years.
This is the same exact spot that was home to the Dana Point time capsule that was put into the ground 50 years ago in an 8-ton boulder, which contained many amazing items placed back here in 1966. At a future date to be determined, the new 50-year time capsule will be placed in its new home here at the modernized harbor.
On Wednesday, August 17th, the Rock was moved from the Cooper Center to its new home in Dana Point Harbor at Baby Beach. Now the Rock can retire with a great view of past surfers and watermen whose spirits still ride the best wave in Southern California. After 4 months of planning, on Monday, August 29th, the day to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the creation of the Dana Point Harbor had come. The event began with a VIP reception for donors and dignitaries held at the Ocean Institute.
And it's very pleasing to see today's supervisor, Lisa Bartlett, carrying the torch and doing wonderful things here in South County also.
Well, I'm a resident of Dana Point, so I wasn't going to miss today. I understand a lot of people who were here for the time capsule are here today and have flown a long ways to get here, so happy to be a part of the event.
Guests enjoyed meeting Miss San Clemente and Miss Dana Point, who helped officiate the 1966 dedication ceremony.
It's 50 years later. Do you have your tickets for the barbecue? And by golly, not only did I have those tickets, I had the letter, and all these years, it was not far from our mind that we would be here.
The main attraction was a private screening of the first cut of this documentary film. Surpassing our expectations, the public dedication ceremony attracted over 1,500 people.
Today we're all here to take an exciting peek into the past. On Monday, August 29th, 1966, exactly 50 years ago today, a special ceremony marked the beginning of the county's construction of Dana Point Harbor. As part of that ceremony, a large 8-ton boulder with a plaque sealing the time capsule inside was placed near the water at the extreme far side of the harbor at Puerto Place. On that day, visitors were promised another ceremony in 2016, which would reveal the contents of the time capsule, and today we're making good on that promise.
Doris described the occasion in detail in her book, Dana Point Harbor, Capistrano Bay, Home Port for Romance. Thanks to Doris, we have the lyrics to the Dana Voyage song sung for us today.
50 years ago, I was an 11-year-old. And I sat with my grandparents as my mother performed a special song for the harbor dedication event in 1966. And little did I know that 50 years later I would fulfill the dreams of my father and my folk singer Mother Mary, performing this song again at the ceremony that my dad wrote the lyrics to and my mom performed. The guitar that I am playing is the exact guitar she played in that event.
Thank you.
If you were at the rock placing ceremony in 1966, please stand. And remain standing. And then I would like everybody here who is related to somebody who was here in 1966, please stand. And this is a reunion of all of you. Thank you so much for being here. At the 1966 Time Capsule Ceremony, the flag presentation was administered by local Boy Scout troop. In keeping with that tradition, 50 years later, we have Boy Scouts of America, Cub Scout Pack 705 of Dana Point, who will present the flag of our great nation.
Color Guard, post the flag.
Someone who was present at the 1966 Time Capsule Ceremony was Doris Walker. She was well known as the foremost expert in South County coastal history. Her 1981 book, Dana Point Harbor, Capistrano Bay, Home Port for Romance, is considered the definitive history for the area. Although Doris passed away 5 years ago, she is with us today in spirit and will certainly not forget her. Today is really about all the people who made the harbor a reality for the enjoyment of so many and for remembering the historic loss of a legendary big wave known as Kiladana.
Following the ceremony, many enjoyed the dinner that had been promised to them 50 years ago.
The last time I was so excited to see something like this was April 21st, 1986. And there was a 2-hour special on TV hosted by Geraldo Rivera. And I waited 2 hours to see the opening of Capone's vault to find nothing inside. Today's event, I promise you, is going to be much more exciting.
Even more amazing was the public interest in viewing the contents of the time capsule.
Space does not, unfortunately, allow us to display all of the capsule's contents today. However, you will see a large selection of the most interesting photos, printed material, correspondence, artifacts, and more.
Thanks to everyone here today who came in celebration of the local, county, state, and federal effort to create this beautiful harbor and recreational area enjoyed by so many of us. Thank you.
The harbor has turned into the crown jewel that it was promised to be 50 years ago.
As we look back 50 years at this present moment, we can't help but also to look forward as well. Perhaps we've heard the riddle, what is more precious than gold and money, but that cannot be earned or saved? It is the gift of time. It is something that none of us have earned, but have been entrusted with.
From the days of Richard Henry Dana, Dana Point has always been a place where dreams were created. In retrospect, the creation of the harbor is just another dream fulfilled. The rock is that gentle voice, reconnecting us to dreams of a simpler time.